remain confident in this. I will see the goodness of the Lord. How many of you know that that's a promise? That is a promise. And the promises of God, as we get ready to leave the house of God, are yes and amen. Look at somebody and say, the promises of God are yes and amen. If he said it, he's gonna do it. Because he's not a God that should lie, or the Son of Man that he should repent. If he spoke it, he's gonna make it good. So we can rejoice as we leave the house of God, declaring over our situation that no matter what it looks like, the promises of God are yes and amen. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Come on, put your hands together right here. Come on. Listen. The promises of God are yes and amen. The promises of God, yes and amen. If he said it, he will do it. The promises of God. The promises of God. The promises of God. Yes, and amen. Come on, help me say. The promises of God are yes and amen. The promises of God, yes and amen. Do it. Oh, the increase you more and more. You and your children, you are blessed of the Lord, which made heaven and earth.
Promises are coming.
Bring all the tithes into my storehouse. And try me that I will open up the windows of heaven.
Promises are coming.
The Lord God is a sun and shield. The Lord will give grace and glory. No good thing will he withhold from you. But unto you that fear my name shall the Son of Righteousness arise with healing in his
wings.
But he was wounded for our transgressions. He was bruised for our iniquity. The chastisement of his peace. And with his stripes we are healed. No weapon formed against me shall prosper. Situation, what you got to go back home to, what you got to go into this week with, and I want you to declare over that thing. Say, come on, say, thing. The promise of God is that I am the head and I'm not the tail. I'm above and I'm not beneath. And I have the victory. Service right here at West Angeles, and it was about maybe what 15 people. people in the room, and the Lord downloaded this song. Why are you saying this, Sister Judy? Because the Lord just dropped in my spirit, there are some of you that need to get in your prayer closet. And as you get in your prayer closet, God will begin to reveal some things to you. As you steal away, away from the noise, away from the clamor, away from the crowd, and you get in the presence of God, the Bible says that he will reveal things. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. He will show you things to come. Glory to God. So how many of you will make a commitment even tonight to get in the presence of God, to steal away in your prayer closet, to let the Lord reveal to you and minister to you in a way that he's never done it before? That's the promise of God. I will reveal my secrets to his prophets. That's what he said. That's a promise. Are you ready? One, two. Received in the house of God. We thank you for your power felt and the expression of your glory upon us. And as we leave this place, we don't leave as others would leave, but we leave with a resolution and an understanding that you have called us to another place, a lifestyle of worship, that we would be living and breathing and talking oracles of your glory in the name of Jesus. And so, Father, as we have our hands lifted to you, we thank you for your precious and your exceeding great promises to us. And the promises of God, somebody say, are yes and amen. One, two, three. Promises of God. Of God, oh yes, and amen. And let's put a praise on it tonight.